In this video, I'm going to talk about division and RISC-V. There are two main ways to divide in RISC-V, using shift-right logical immediate and shift-right arithmetic immediate. The two main differences between the two is how they handle sign extension, where with shift-right arithmetic immediate, it will keep the sign extension. Shift-right logical immediate will push your bits to the right without accounting for sign extension. Let's try an example using negative 8. So if we were to use shift right logical immediate, the command would look something like, let's say we're going to store the result into T1. We'll say that T0 is equal to negative 8. And we want to just divide by 2. Keep the situation the same on this side. And remember, it's 1 because when you shift the bits to the right, that's dividing it by 2. And it would be the same for multiplication. If you shift to the left, you're multiplying it by 2. So let's go ahead, and what we're going to do is we are going to push all of these bits to the right. Same on this side as well. And we want to see the difference between the two. Now when we do it logically, we are not worried about this sign extension. So what happens is we just add a 0 and we just push everything to the right. So in T1, it's going to hold the value of 0, 1, 0, 0. Now however, on shift right arithmetic immediate, it's going to say, okay, this is a 1, we have to add a 1, so T1 is going to hold the value of 1, 1, 0, 0. So what's actually being stored in T1 on shift right logical immediate is no longer a negative number. It's actually equal to 4. Now on shift right arithmetic immediate, when we divided 8 by 2, this converted it into, remember this is 2's complement, so we could easily just convert this to the positive and just remember that it's negative, or you can just add them up. So this would be negative 8 plus 4. So this is negative 4, or if you just wanted to, remember, we just take these bits, so this would become 0, 1, 0, 0. This is the positive 2's complement. Which is equal to 4. So we know that that checks out, but just remember that it's negative. And over here, it's just positive 4. Because it logically shifted to the right and didn't account for this most significant bit being negative. Now this is directly from an online compiler, just to show you in the compiler what it would look like. And we can see our final results in decimal, hex, and binary. So what I did is I just put in negative 10 into T0. So it's negative 10, and it is sine extended in hex with all f's, and it is sine extended in binary with all 1's. Now on our second line, I did the logical immediate and I stored it into T1. So we can see T1, what it did is it shifted, but this got turned to 0. It didn't concern itself with the fact that it was a negative number, so it right shifted. And this is a complete word, so this number is just massive because it's no longer a negative number. It just got right shifted, and all these ones and bits got pushed to the right, leaving this zero. However, in the shift right arithmetic immediate, dividing by 2, storing it into register T2, you see we get negative 5. And this is because its sign extends. When it pushes to the right, it keeps this 1, or it adds this 1. It concerns itself. So majority of the time when you were dividing, you were most likely going to be using the shift right arithmetic immediate. I hope this video was helpful and you found some use and value in this. Consider liking and subscribing, and until next time, thank you.